Hello guys, today we are going to discuss about the Vanderwall equation of state. In previous class we have done ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to nRT. Now we are going to the Vanderwall equation of state. He has made two reactions in the pressure and volume. Now it is written for 1 mole P plus A by V square and V minus B equal to RT, and if we go for n number of moles, this equation can be written as P plus A n square by V square multiply V minus NB equals to nRT for n mole of gases. Now he has made two corrections. Number one is for volume correction. Actually, when ideal gas, the volume of ideal gas can be taken as a container volume of container hole. But whenever we are approaching it in the real gas, then real gas can be compressed and it will get less volume. Then what is left? That is B, that is called excluded volume. And actually, it is the closest approach of two molecules, and it becomes the closest approach of two molecules to R. And we will say that excluded volume is B and known as, which is the compressible, non-compressible volume. For 2R, it is the closest approach. In simple word, we can say that the B is the non-compressible volume of a gas. So B stands for is a constant, and simple words, B is non-compressible volume. Non-compressible volume. And we can show by this one, 2R means 2N is equal to 4 by 3 pi R cube, and then because of that R is equal to 2R, then it becomes 2N is equal to 8 into 4 by 3 pi R cube, and then N is equal to come 4 multiply 4 by 3 pi R cube. In the mathematical language, simply we can say that the volume which cannot be compressed, that is called excluded volume, and that stands for B, and which has been discovered by the Vanderwall. And next, the pressure correction. Now finally, for the volume, ideal volume is equal to available volume minus non-compressible volume. And now for pressure correction, ideal pressure is equal to actual pressure plus pressure of the surrounding particles. And pressure will depend upon the number of particles per unit of volume, and also on the total number of molecules which are attracting such molecules, that is directly proportional to density. Means of that, pressure is directly proportional to density, and density directly proportional to number of moles per liter of the solution, that is the concentration. And it is happening two times. Number one, its own pressure, its own density, that is N by V. And then surrounding particles. Suppose that this is a student A who is on the bank of the river. So when he is putting his foot on the river, his own pressure, number of particles per unit volume, and the surrounding particles which are in between the water, they are also pulling inside, then N by V more. It means two time D is working. So total inward pull on this particle A is given by this one. Total inward pull is directly proportional to N by V of the particle ones multiplied with one more N by V Then finally, pressure is directly proportional to N square by V square. And then P is equal to what? P is equal to A N square by V square. Now the ideal pressure becomes what? P plus A N square by V square. So finally he had given, this is the correction in the pressure he has made. Finally, Vanderwall equation for n number of moles will be written like this. P plus A n square by V square multiply with V minus nB and it becomes nRT. So, for n number of molecules, this one becomes the Vanderwall gas equation. The important thing for the 11th standard student, you must have to learn, he can put you the question, what stand A and B in the Vanderwall gas equation? So both are the constant, and A stand for force of attraction and B is the excluded volume. And my dear student, in the next class we will discuss the surface tension and viscosity coefficient eta. Till then, goodbye. Bye-bye.